Not only death, which shakes and rends all that is human in us, creating a monstrous separation and threatening the soul with isolation that destroys. Not only death, but that accompaniment of mortality which is a perpetual series of lesser deaths and is called change, is challenged, chained, and put in its place by unaltered and successive acts of seasonable regard for loss and dereliction and mutability. The threats of despair, remorse, necessary expiation, weariness almost beyond bearing, dull repetition of things apparently fruitless, unnecessary and without meaning, estrangement, the misunderstanding of mind by mind, forgetfulness, which is a false alarm, grief and repentance, which are true ones, but of a sad company. Young men perished in battle before their parents had lost vigor of age. The perils of sickness in the body and even in the mind. Anxiety, honor harassed, all the bitterness of living. Become part of a large business which may lead to beatitude. For they are all connected in the memory with holy day after holy day, year by year, binding the generations together, carrying on even in this world, as it were, the life of the dead, and giving corporate substance, permanence, and stability, without the symbol of which, at least, the vast increasing burden of life might at last conquer us and be no longer borne.